in this momentous event, International Public Lecturer between Pakuan University from Bogor, Indonesia, and Ailma University from Pakistan. Topic for today is a marketing strategy for banking in 2021 for international perspective. Distinguished lecturers and students from economic and business faculty, let us begin this event with greeting to our honorable guests, Excellency Dr. Naima Antlip. This online meeting will be divided into two agendas, Dr. Aima. The first agenda is about presentation from your side. It's about 1 hour, and then you can take more if you need it. And then the second agenda is Q&A, or question and answers. I hope that all participants, students, or all maybe lecturers can have a question. You can write down in a box, or maybe you can raise up so I can give you a chance to asking you a question. Let me a little bit introduce Dr. Naima Antlip. I really appreciate and surprised with all the achievement that you made so far. As far as I know that your research area is technology, management, marketing, and also human resource. You've been under PhD program of technology and marketing in University Tun Hussein on Malaysia, Batu Pahat, Malaysia. And then you finished your postgraduate program, MBA marketing in Superior University Lahore. And then your bachelor is BCom, Federal Urdu University of Art, Science and Technology. And then your doctorate dissertation is the effect of organizational culture and internal marketing on employee activity with the knowledge sharing as a mediator in Islamic banking. And then speaking about your professional experience, I do believe that you have a very perfect combination or mix, because you came from the campus as a background, and also you have a professional background also. The first one, from the CV or resume that I got, you are one of the lecturer, research associate in Ailma University in Karongi Creek, Karachi. And then also before that, you are the country co-investigator or CCI from BD School, Simon Fraser in University, Canada. And then research assistant, work as a research assistant for Dr. Cha Xiao Wei in University of Tun Hussein on Malaysia. And then your professional career, you were ACK branch manager in Samba Bank Limited, Faisal Town branch, Lahore, Pakistan, and also relationship manager back to 2012, NIB Bank now acquired by Muslim Commercial Bank. Okay, this is very amazing. And also you have an award and a distinction. This is a received 5th International Conference and on Applied Science and Technology in ICAS 2019 at Tistol, Johar Bahru, Johar, Malaysia. Last but not least, you have one book and also many journal that I cannot mention one by one. And then this is very outstanding and marvelous achievement. All right, ladies and gentlemen, lecturer and student, please give warm welcome to our Excellency Dr. Naima Antlip to present about marketing strategy for banking in 2021 for international perspective. Okay, Dr. Naima, the time is yours. Maybe you need our help to,
share the slides.
Yeah. Or you maybe prefer do it by yourself?
Wait, I will try to share the slides. Then I will see what happened. I can share or not.
All right. Okay, please.
Is everyone able to see?
I think, okay. That's perfect. You can see it.
Okay.
Clearly.
Okay. Let me arrange this from my side. Thank you. Assalamu alaikum, all of the participants.
Wa alaikum salam.
First of all, I would like to pay my regards to everyone, and especially to Pakuan University, and then to Dr. Farah Jawaridia, And after that, our moderator. Today, we are going to share the knowledge about marketing strategies for banking sector in 2021 for international perspective. I think so. I don't need to give my introduction again because already our moderator introduced me. So I think so. You all agree, dear moderator? Are you agree?
100% agreed, Dr. Naima.
Okay. Then I will go ahead. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Rabbi shrahli sadri wa yassir li amri wa hlul 'uqdatam min lisani yafqahu qawli. Okay. Now I will start. Does banks play a significant role or life is more comfortable without banking sector? So if I go to discuss this point, either bank play a significant role in our lives or not, I think so it's better I will talk about our previous banking, previous area when there was no bank. What people do? People use different means, like they put their money in pillow, that is their bank. They put their money in soft, that is their bank, or they hide their money in different places. Even they don't have any chance to do their business on a wider point, like international transaction. Students cannot go on an international platform while performing very easy and free. Like if Dr. Yuari Faradiya, if we both were in that era, then we both need to bring the money in cash and give to the university instead of paying by ATM, by credit card. Then we give them, please take our money. We have to deposit our fee. Oh, we cannot bring our fee here. So these kind of difficulties and barriers people faced while we are not facing. And after that, once banking sector becomes and formulating, like banking sector, how banking sector becomes formulating. There were six gangs from America, and they start these kind of activities. They took the money from people and then they lent the money to other people and charged them interest. Even they, if a poor person was not able to pay the interest, they beat them, they threat them. And after that, this concept start expanding, and then banking sector becomes formulated. And after that, once banking sector comes in the market, and then technology formations, things are coming. And alhamdulillah, now we people are in the area where all things are very easy. And we can say this banking is modernized banking. Okay, I think so. This finds you clear that banking sector is very important in our life because the people can interact internationally, people can do international businesses easily, people can have credit cards, debit cards in the shape of plastic money. They don't need to go and bring the cash with them and take the lot of risk. Okay, then what is bank? The previous thing that I discussed, banks are the financial institution that accept deposits from the public and create a demand. Simultaneously, they are engaged in making the loan. Okay. Now, because our area is, we are going to see the marketing strategies in the banking sector. So the banking sector, the one who most in need for marketing strategies is the commercial banks. Because there are other types of the banking sector, investment banks, development banks, but that kind of banks don't need doing the marketing strategies to acquire the customer. But the commercial banks, public commercial bank have three branches, public bank, private bank, and foreign bank. So if we talk about the public bank, the public banks are the banks that are under the government of any country, like our public bank, National Bank of Pakistan, Punjab Bank of Pakistan. Then the private banks are the banks who owned by the other persons, other entities. Okay, and the foreign banks, like foreign banks, we can say are the banks that are owned by foreign parties. Like we can say in the previous picture, you can say Barclays. I think so everyone knows Barclays because it exists in any country. HBSC, everyone knows. This is Hong Kong Bank. Okay, Citibank knows, people knows. Okay. Then we go ahead. what banking sector plays a role in individual level? Like, I'm an individual. My audience, I don't know. There are people who are doing their businesses. There are people who are doing their jobs. But at an individual level, how bank give us the benefit? We can deposit our money. We can withdraw our money. Okay, we can keep the savings in the shape. Like, I do have some money, 1 million, we can say. And then I go to the bank because I think so I cannot multiply my money. I think so I should put my money on the saving account. And then I went to the bank and put my money in the saving account. And I asked them, give me a good rate. Maybe they give me 2%, 3% on my saving account. Then after that, I can utilize the saving and let my money there. So this is also a saving thing that bank is giving to the advantage of individuals, okay? So I can get the investment plans. Like if I say I am right now single, young, I can invest my money that later on in my age, I can utilize that money. So in this perspective, this is the saving plans that many banks giving to their customers to acquire more customers in the bank. Then financial assistance, there are many banks who are providing the financial assistance to their clients. Like I was in the bank, I always look to the clients to advise them, this is the right thing and this is the wrong thing for you. This product is good, you should invest in this product, you shouldn't go to this product. So always a good banker advise to their customer, invest your monies in this way. Okay, after that, bank is also providing cashless transactions by offering plastic money to their customers. Plastic money would be in the shape of credit card, debit card, or any other kind of facility that bank offer to their customers. Checking account means a bank can open the accounts of the customers and allow them to check the balance while using mobile app, while using internet banking or any way. Okay. International transactions and loans also are provided to the customers from the bank. Like there are the bank in our world who are providing the loans to the customers, like in the shape car loan, house loan, auto loan, and other kind of loans. Like if the student, our here in Pakistan, there is a bank, Nissan Bank. They offer students to the loan who wants to buy a laptop. They offer laptop loans to the students. And there are the banks who offer to the students loan for education. Later on, they can pay the installment, they can do the things, and they just utilize that loan for their education. I hope this thing will be in the scene in every country. Most importantly, developing and developed countries really need these things from the banks to give the education to the students to lead their countries by providing them good education. Okay, fund transfer facility, like I was a student, and I have to pay the fee in UTHM always. And if I am sitting in Pakistan, I just utilize my debit card, credit card, and pay the fee to there. This is a really good facility. Otherwise, it would be a problem for me. And you all know these kind of problems actually break us. At the business perspective, what kind of role a banking sector plays? So a banking sector plays a role in the shape of trading facilities to international and national level. Okay, there are customers who are doing the things. There are people who are doing the business and doing the trading like import and export. So bank is a very useful mediator to open the LCs, to transfer their amounts there and brings their amount. So that's why this is a very useful mean that bank is facilitating to the clients, and even these clients included in corporate clients. So the bank is providing a very, very wealthy role for corporate clients as well. Loan advance payments. Okay, the loans also, we understand loans in the shape of like buying the machinery, buying the assets for the business, and advance payments. What is the advance payments? I think so. If anyone knows about the advance payments, it's okay. I will left it. But I think so. I should make the clear to this point. There are people who are doing the businesses. Then they need to transfer their money on regular basis to their other party. Then they took a amount, certain amount from the bank in their another account that is called also business account. If they don't have money, then they transfer that amount from that advance amount. And then after that, they pay that amount within 1 or 2 days or 3 days with the markup of using that amount. And the businesses who are getting the advance payments, that is not in a small form, like that is 2 million, 3 million, 5 million, this kind of things. Bank is facilitating to the customers. If bank is not doing these kind of things, then I think so if I invest and then I cannot make the payment to my party, to next party on time, then they will cancel the contract immediately and put me out from the network. Right. Working capital is also like providing the working capital. This is also same like advance payments or things like people are utilizing term loans, like short-term loans, long-term loans. There are some businesses who are getting 3 months loan, 5 months, 5 years, 10 years, 20 years. And even our governments, whenever the governments change, they just comes to the bank and ask them to give the loan to run the matters, okay? And banks are also providing these services to our governments, because the developing countries, always government is hungry, okay? Letter of guarantee will be issued to a client who is doing the trade activities to another country, then they get issued the letter of guarantee, letter of credit, the both things, and fund transfer and remittances are in the shape. Like if a person, like if I am working outside of Pakistan, like let's suppose I can say I am a faculty of Pakwan University and I need to send my amount to Pakistan. I will remit the amount in Pakistan, like through fund transfer or remittance. This medium I can use. Bill discounting term is also used while doing the trade activities. In trade activities, bill discounting facility, if someone is from chartered accountancy or BCom field, the people know bill discounting because there is a complete chapter about this. Okay. Export financing is also when businesses are doing things and they want to export the things. They are, if running low of the budget, they can get the finances from bank and then export their things. Okay. Then the challenges and opportunities for banking industry during COVID-19. Because in the modern banking right now, what we are doing and where we are heading to, we are still, it's been 2 years, all of the world is facing the challenges from COVID-19. It's drastic. It broke many people, many of the businesses, and many businesses has been knocked down and then they swept out. So what kind of opportunities and what kind of challenges banking facing here? The challenges for banking industry are the thing that people, all of the people around the world, approximately sitting at home. So no one is going outside. Like if I'm lecturer, I don't need to go outside. I have to stay at my home. I cannot go outside. So while I was going outside, I was driving, and in my way, there are many banks, like 5, 10, 20 banks. I can see the branding of the bank. I can see this branch, that branch. I can just do my matters and transactions from the bank. And there are many things that comes in my mind. Oh, I need to do this. I have to deposit. I have to withdraw. I have to invest. I can put my some amount in investments. But due to COVID-19, what I realized, I think so better to put my amount in fixed deposit or in long-term investment, I need to put my amount in an account where my money is a hot cash. Anytime I can withdraw, anytime I can deposit. But majority of the people, what they are looking for, they try to keep 30%, 40% of the whole amount of their money in hand. In any difficulty, at any time they can need it, they can utilize it. In this way, when the visibility is always, people are not going outside, so it is the less of the visibility. Due to less of visibility, the banks are losing the profits because activities are not doing as previously. And then like banks are losing the profit because marketing is not happening. The marketing that was free for banks, like every person is going outside and looking the branches, that is free marketing. So that's why they cannot see it. Credit risk also, banks are facing digital banking. What does mean here digital banking? Previously, during COVID-19, banks are actively working to bring the digital banking, but previously the banking trend of using digital banking was not actively, even me, doing many things, but was not using actively digital banking. I was just using going to ATM, withdraw the cash, going to branch, withdraw and deposit the cash, and then what I do, just transfer the money on counter. So even there was a not proper and developed way were followed in many countries for digital banking, but now they are following. The threats, cyber threats are coming from outside. Business continuity was at stake for banks also because there are number of competitors in the market. So what the people have facing, the people are facing business continuity issues. The crisis management is also there for them to manage. So in this era, almost banks are losing the profits and they are the stability of the banks were at stake. Okay, fine. The opportunities for banking industry was also there during COVID-19. What opportunity they gain? Implementing the digital marketing for customers and getting the benefits, rethinking cost reduction strategy, effective digital marketing strategies were also implementing. And then this was the way they can gain the benefit. Okay, for the next. The role that COVID-19 that were performed by banks in the era of COVID-19, there are different important steps that I'm going to discuss during the pandemic has been happened. First, what banks did. Every organization, when the staff of every organization were sitting at the home, only the hospitals, only the grocery stores and the banks were there to perform active roles. And they engage their employees to their frontliners to perform their duties by rotating and by following the SOPs. Even many of the banks put their employees like do this task. And then they manage to do the things during COVID-19. So that's why customer can be facilitated. Providing cash flow to the cash flow support. Though customer also provide cash flow support to their customers, like to business persons and to individuals also. So that's why they can cope themselves in this time period for their sustainability. Lowering the cost of lending. What is that mean, lowering the cost of lending? Means bank is giving the loans to the customers, to the employees as well. Then they just reduce the rate of return, like rate of interest for that lending. Means if they are charging 8%, then they start charging 7, 6, like this. Okay, providing new kinds of lending and lending to managerial borrowers and helping customers do their banking digitally. Because previously digital banking was not much developed. Now they are implementing more comfortable developed techniques, so that's why customer can be safe, comfortable, and they can do their transaction and things peacefully on one click. Okay, fine. The point is here that we are going to talk about marketing plans and strategies. My question is, what helps to banks to stay competitive in international marketing during COVID-19? There are two things that shows in this slide. Marketing plans, one, and strategies, two. Okay. Further, effective marketing plan and strategies are critical to avail the opportunities and deal with the challenges. Okay, you can see the pictures here also showing that how the things can happen. An effective plan and strategy is very important for banks to deal with the challenges and gain the opportunities out of challenges. Is marketing really necessary and worth having? Yes. Okay, I can say yes, but I have examples to give. Brands that fail due to ineffective marketing strategies. There are different brands, and I think so everyone knows this brand, Nokia. Nokia is the one around the world everyone knows, and I think so. Now the people who are around 40, above 40, they were the one who used this, because even in that times, the people who were financially very stable, they used Nokia mobile. And after that, Nokia just kicked out from the market because of their marketing strategies. Kodak, every country, everyone knows what is Kodak and how they just kicked out from the market. HMP, this brand is also now, we cannot see. Sony, there is nowhere. Walkman is the brand, actually is a device from the Sony brand, but there is no more concept for Walkman. Now we use just our mobiles for all of the purposes. Okay. Mission and objectives of marketing. So first we talk about the mission. What is the mission for marketing? Financial services, providing the financial services and financial stability for the bank, financial services to the client, market penetration, making more branches and penetrating the market. So that's why I expand the business. Customer base, increasing the customer base, because previously there was the trend for banks to gain valuable customers with handsome deposit is enough for us to gain the profit. Now banks understand, if one valuable customer, like if one customer have worth 30 million, 40 million, and that one person becomes annoyed to us and that he brings his deposit to another bank, we will be impressed. So that's why they are following the strategy to increase the customer from the base. Either that are for small deposit, that are all kind of customers they are trying to bring in. Okay. The objective. Actually, objectives are in terms like growth in income. These are objectives actually formulated when every bank, every organization is trying to making the plan. Their things should be in their mind, and they keep the things in their mind. Why? We are going to spend this amount on the marketing, on doing the marketing strategies, on doing the marketing campaigns. Then what will we gain in the return? So it. Income growth, it will raise by 8%. Target new customers will increase by 5% at least. Increase product and service sale of existing customer at least by 3%. We have right, because we are spending a lot of amount on marketing campaigns and marketing strategies. After that, increase return on investment by 10%, reduce bank cost 3%, increase customer satisfaction by 2%. Okay. Now we are going to discuss about the marketing mix for banks. I think so the people who are from marketing, they know marketing mix, 5Ps, 6Ps. So for banks, this marketing mix is quite a little bit the similar, but there are more things in it. Like product and service. In the product, credit card, fund transfer, guarantee of services, corporate risk management services, and then if we see price, preferential interest rate. If we are introducing a credit card and we impose higher preferential rate, like we are charging the higher rate, it happens one of the bank in Pakistan, what happened? They introduced credit card first time, I think so 15 years ago. The management, they put their lot of efforts to introduce the credit card. They put lot of money and then design a marketing plan. But what they did, they impose high interest rate. What they gain? Mostly people don't prefer to pay high interest rate. They now they were not able to bring the customers in and buy the credit card while they invest lot of amount. I think so if they give the lower interest rate, they can get many customers, and after that in the calculation, in the sum, they can get a better profit. But they never design it like this. Then after that, that bank is Bank Al-Fula, they did this. Okay, competitive deposit rate. Still, this if the customer is keeping their deposit in the account, then it happens to me also. Once we do have a client, he do have deposit, and deposit amount is good. Then they ask us, okay, give us a good rate for deposit. Otherwise, we will check on the market. If they get a good deposit rate in other bank, they just go to their. Okay, marketing mix for banks. Again, skilled people should be part of the bank. Training programs should be part of the bank. If bank is not providing the training programs properly, then they will lose, because while they providing the training programs, their employees becomes a train. If they are very very like slow in providing the training programs, it's not good at all. Okay, fine. Even once I found this, there are some banks, like they hire a badge for customer relationship officers. I am not going to quote the name of that bank. It will be backbiting. They hire a badge of the staff, customer relationship officers, and then they place this badge in the market. They never provide the trainings to them. What happens? They failed in mystery shopping. They fail in all kind of tests, and then they fail in properly dealing with the customers, with the clients. When a client comes to the CRO and asks about the product line, what product line you do have? They don't know. They will tell, "Next, I don't know. I will tell you what kind of subjects I read in my MBA." Nothing. And then process. Account can be opened through all banking channels, social responsibility on credit limits, and then visibility should be the part. Visibility is one kind of marketing. This is one kind of marketing strategy. Visibility of all branches and logos is properly and eye-catching. Team of professional staff members should be all also part of the banking sector. Then marketing mix for banks, again, the promotion and place. Promotion through different channels, above the line and below the line technique should be followed. Above the line and below the line technique means a bank need to target all of the customers and make the segmentation, what kind of products we are giving to the top customers and what kind of products we are giving the below customers, because there are few top customers, but there are a lot of mediocres, and there are a lot of below mediocres. So that's why banks should need to design the strategies in this way. Travel magazines like in aeroplane, in tubes, or in other things that we are going and traveling, like and displaying the TVs and LCDs, and also travel agent websites. If we are looking at travel agent's website, there are sometimes ads are coming on the sites. So this is also a way to give the promotion. Popular TV channels, the TV channel that people are mostly watching, that TV channels can be targeted to place our promotions. Okay, about the place. wider range of branches, a bank that have number of branches like 600, 700 branches, that bank is the one bank that can get the more deposit. Because if like, if I do have account in HVL, then I will prefer to ask my sister, my brother, you should have account in this bank. So that's why if I need or you need any service, then I can easily transfer amount. Also, banks are also using for the purpose of fee deposit, for the purpose of many, many things. So if a bank have a number of branches, then the clients, the corporate clients also target that bank to open the account for their business, to open the account for their schools, colleges, and universities. So that's why students can easily anywhere from anywhere can deposit. Internet banking, ATM machines. Okay. Then marketing strategies of 2021 in banking for international perspective. Okay. Dear moderator, do we need to take a break or not?
I don't think so, Dr. Aima, because I think everyone's still very interested. You can carry on, because I do believe that you have a very interesting video, right, after this one. So we better continue.
Okay, thank you. Okay, then I'm going to talk about the marketing strategies for 2021 in banking sector in international perspective. What internationally people or banking management can do to promote the bank. Every country have different banking sector, but for the promotion, every country can target a little bit different things, but the mediums can be same. Like little bit different things in a perspective. Like if they are giving a promotion, they are giving an ad, they should use their kind of population. They should use their faces, the faces that are close to their country faces. So that's why marketing strategies of 2021 in banking for international perspective is there are proposed best marketing wait. Close the door and go. Sorry.
No problem at all.
Demographic targeting. Demographic targeting in the sense demographic data should be taken from the general public, like age groups, and after that income. After that, what kind of means the people are using. So these kind of demographic should be part of the banking sector. So that's why anyone can target a good customers. Then blogging is also a very viral and good way to promote the medium or promote the banking sector. Then technology adoption, what we people are doing in this era, at least technology adoption, adopting new technology mediums, using different kind of apps. Even previously there was a time when banks doesn't have mobile apps. Now we just go to the Play Store. We just, if you are using iPhone, you just go to the that app. Then you can just install your app and you are easy. That kind of apps also trusted. If you just go and download an other app from internet, that app maybe cause virus or anything. But now every industry and every like banking sector have apps. Okay, digital apps. These are also kind of things in technology adoption, and digital apps is more or less similar. Okay, customer value. We need to provide the value to our customers. Without giving the value, we cannot attract the customers to our bank. Even if we are at a time entertaining bundle of customers, we are dealing with many clients. But if the new one is entering and we are just ignoring, then we cannot gain. If you are busy with money, then at least you should give the gesture, have a seat. So this thing is very important for a banker to pay the value. Okay, dear moderator, can we play this link?
Oh, yeah. Actually, we already prepared for that one. I mean, if you don't mind, Dr. Naima, maybe you can stop share screen for a while, because I will ask Mr. Ekta, yeah, to assist or to play the video for you, yeah. Okay. So for meanwhile, do you mind if we stop the share screen from your side for a while? Is it okay?
Yes, it's okay for me. Otherwise, we can play the both at the end.
No problem. Actually, we already prepare for your videos, and then we already downloaded. Okay. Please, Mr. Eka, you can proceed for that one.
Yes, sir. I'm open this video.
All right. Don't forget about the audio, Ms. Aiga.
Hello there. Hi.
Hi.
I'm here to thank you.
You're welcome.
Hi, Christine.
Bonjour, Karine.
Bonjour.
Hi, Michael.
Hi.
I'm ATM. You know what ATM stands for?
Automated teller machine.
That is correct, normally, but today you're wrong. I'm an automated thanking machine.
Hey, look at that, buddy.
That's for you. That's on TV Canada Trust.
Thank you.
Ooh, selfie. Get my good side.
There's a slot that's opening.
Oh my goodness. Never in all my life had such a beautiful surprise.
Yeah, you've been helping your daughter out, is that correct?
Yes.
We've got something for you, Christine. There's something that's about to come out there. Those are two piggy banks. Those are for your kids. Well, we've got a little something for you because you're a famous customer. We know you love the Jays so much. Look on the other side of me. There's another slot that's going to open up. On the left side there, yeah. It's going to open up.
That's awesome!
She's my only daughter. She has cancer and she had an operation on Tuesday.
We wanted to thank you in a very specialized way. There's actually a card coming out for you right there. And if you look inside each piggy bank, there's a check for $1,000 to start an RESP for each of your kids.
Woo-hoo!
Yes.
Yeah, right.
That outfit. Well, the thanking's not done, Christy.
What?
Here's the thing. If you tell your kids, hey, here's an RESP, they'll be all, nah. But if you tell them you're taking them to a place like Disney.
No.
Yes, you're taking your kids to a magical place in California, Christine.
I've never been able to take your kids anywhere.
It's wonderful that you've been with us for so long. That we got somebody who might want to talk to you for a second about that.
Oh my God.
During this time, we have come to know how giving, loving, and supportive you are, especially to your daughter in Trinidad. She's a lucky woman to be able to call you mom.
So I just threw you a ball, but someday you'll be throwing me a ball.
Oh my God.
You'll be throwing out the first pitch.
That is awesome. That is awesome. I got goosebumps right now.
Actually, Dorothy, could you lean in for a second? Because I have a secret to tell you. Just lean in very close. We want you to thank her yourself. So we've got something coming out of the slot right now. Something right there for you. And those are tickets. Those are tickets to Trinidad.
Are you serious?
I am serious. You're going to go see your daughter in Trinidad.
That's rude.
Yeah. Oh, thank you, Dorothy.
Wow, no way. That's a very beautiful video. Very interactive ATM, right? That's definitely awesome. Do you still have any video, Dr. Naima?
Yes, in this slide, there is one more video. I think.
Oh, one more video. All right. I think we cannot wait for a long time. Yeah. Okay, Mr. Eka, maybe you can proceed for the second video. Are you ready for that?
Yes, sir. Okay. I'm open this video next. Waiting a minute.
Okay.
Okay.
All right. That's definitely awesome.
Yes, that's right. This video.
Hi, Christiana. CIBC is giving you a travel voucher so you can take a break when this is all over.
Second video shows how bank give the value of it. I think so. I need to share the slides again. Second video shows that how bank doing content video marketing and campaigns. While in this era, they are giving the value to the frontliners, either that is their staff and that is frontliners like from hospitals or from others. Okay, I was at the point giving customers value. I think so. The video link that we opened for showing the customer value, this has been done from ITU Bank. They did this campaign. I really love this way, how they give the value to the customer to attract the customer. I think so that customer will never ever go anywhere because they just catch their customers in any way. Okay, personalization. This is also a way of marketing, like personalization. If you are providing the personal services, a personal banker to the customer, like the personal banker, they advise the customers according to their worth, according to their needs, how a customer have the value, what kind of jobs the people are doing, then they give them the advices. So this is the personalization or personal banking we can call. And sometimes there are banks, they just for this purpose, they hire personal bankers. Loyalty programs, there are different loyalty programs, customer value video also showing the loyalty program example also in this. Prioritization customer experience. Like prioritization customer experience is a campaign, like if you find there are 10, 20 customers or in your branch or around the bank, you find there are customers who are loyal with your bank, who are very the punctual one doing the transactions, and you do have very good terms with them. You bank arrange an event, like in Samba Bank. What Samba Bank did, they called a famous singer and they arrange a dinner for the clients, and they give that dinner to them, and then they give the speeches. They invited all of the management of the bank, so that's why they can feel privileged. So these kind of things, activities can be done for prioritize. Even if the banking management is not agreed, not willing to spend a lot of expense in this way, but the banker itself can do. The branches itself can do, because every branch do have their budgets to entertain the clients. So it is depend on the banker. It is depend on the branch or branch manager, how the people are doing and how the people are dealing with the things. Okay. And then the last point we already have covered in the video also for frontliners. I will go ahead. So marketing strategies of 2021 are also a heading here. Non-traditional reward programs. There are reward programs that customer value video also shows, and also given the reward programs on everyone is using, I think so, credit card or debit card. There is a program they introduce a 5% cashback or this kind of thing. This is called reward programs. Bank give different things to entertain their customers. So that's why they can use their facility maximum. See, if I got 5% cashback, I don't have need to pay the cash. I just everywhere, whenever I need to spend money. If I need to pay the fee, I will use that medium to pay the fee because I know I will get this point and this cashback. So I think so better to use that medium. Okay. When designing a reward program, your customer consider three primary goals. Increasing customer loyalty should be our goal. Retention them for a long time, long term with us. Cross promotion service and products. Like cross promotion service and product is also a way to bring the customers to us, like offering them. You are using this product. If you start using this product, it will help you because you are this product user. You don't have to pay the charges for this product. You can use this product of the banking. Like we can sell our product, but we also can get a cross product by benefit by giving the customer a product. Strategic partnership. Strategic partnership is also a way to bringing them in a one place and in a one stage. And community initiative, they taking the community initiative like community activities and participating in the community activities. Like there are different banks here, HBL, they offer different kind of community activities. And also there is Misan Bank who offer laptop loans on a little bit and low markup. That is also a community activities. And also if they are sponsoring to a non-profit organization, then they are also doing the community initiative and activities. Okay, I will go ahead. Here's a point, this would be our last slide. I will not take a lot of time from you people. I think so I'm going to get bored for all of you. Marketing strategies followed in 2021 and in Pakistan. First, email promotions. I think so all of you are getting emails from your banks. If not, it's strange. Digital marketing activities. There are many mediums that bank is doing digital marketing, and our client are getting the benefits for digital marketing. Mobile promotions, yes. Still, I'm in Pakistan and I'm getting the promotion of bank Mamulat from Malaysia. Storytelling, content writing, content marketing. The content marketing is the one that we saw in our second video. Okay, logo design. The logo of the bank should be in a way that anyone can see prominently. Like if a bank does have their logo, like there is a bakery and besides the bakery is the bank. If this a person is going and say, oh, bakery and bank both have same logos. What is the difference between bakery? Oh, this is alarming situation. So banks should be designing their logos, their marketing, their brandings very carefully. Previously, many years, I think so 10 or 15 years back, if we saw bank only do have their signage without branding. Branding means because bank has glass doors, they should have branding that shows from outer side their pictures and their celebrities, whatever the slogan bank is using, that should be visible that people can see, oh, okay, this is the bank and this is the branding of our bank, okay, done. These kind of things previously never been done, but now, because we are going and we are in a modern banking right now, these things are happening, okay? Social media networks, like social networks using different mediums, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and there are many more mediums that are using. And so these kind of mediums should be used. Even storytelling, different stories, successful stories for the bank can be used here. Okay, blogging, blogging, we already have been discussed, but the strategies we are discussing here is has been followed in Pakistan and Pakistani marketing. Still, we are also using blogging, making the celebrity as identity. In Pakistan, all banks have different celebrities as identity. If in this session there are people from Pakistan, if I say HBL, they immediately knows, oh, Mr. Bean. Mr. Bean comes in their minds. Because Mr. Bean is a celebrity that becomes the sign for banking. I'm sorry, I should also post the picture of Mr. Bean with the HBL branding, but it's okay. If anyone can see, they can go to the Google and find out. Magazines, even traveling magazines, also should be part of this, and they are doing their brandings for this medium. Advertisement from different mediums like from TV channels, and even if you go into the bank, they do have their LCD. They continuously play the promotions and different products on that TV. That is also a way of advertisement. And even if we are driving from the roads and we are going from a main road, there are LCDs, a big LCDs placed on the roads. Then that LCDs, like banks or any of the organization, the people have to pay money to give the advertisement. To give their advertisement, then they can play their ads there. Also, they can use different channels like YouTube is very common. Even sometimes I just got sick, I play recitation and I am just listening Surah Yasin and start, and wow, what is this? So this kind of medium they can use, and they are currently using in Pakistan. These kind of strategies banks are using currently. Okay, finally, this slide, actually, this slide, the link here, I think so we should give to all our audience. This link contains many books, around 100 or more than 100. The books contains marketing strategies and marketing plans and of every kind of knowledge that we are looking for as a marketer. So there are little bit headings I gave it here, how to create a marketing plan for your business, a step-by-step guide to marketing planning, how to develop a marketing budget, like this. And there are many, many more books in this link we can find that are related to marketing, especially. So, thank you so much for your attention, all of you. I hope I never try to bore any of you. I try my best. There were a lot of things for me I have to share, but I need to be within the time.
Okay, thank you very much. Wow, I think that's very outstanding presentation, and thank you very much for your attractive presentation, Dr. Naima, which is, I mean, that's combining with a very, very nice video, yeah? Please, once again, everyone, give a big applause to Dr. Naima. Okay. It's not a regular opportunity for us to have such an international public lecturer, especially about the banking, right? So maybe you can take a cup of coffee first, or maybe a drink, because you've done your quite long presentation. Please take your time, Dr. Naima, and please make yourself comfortable, because actually I already have one also. So you can have a cup of coffee. Yeah, please.
Thank you.
After that, I almost forgot that this event is actually was held due to contribution of our beloved Dr. Faradia. Dr. Faradia is actually one of the maybe most the favorite lecturer in Pakuan University, and then give many contribution and positive effect to our university. And I do believe maybe we call it in Islam is the power of silaturahim. Is it correct, Dr. Naima? The power of silaturahim, right? All right.
Yeah.
Okay, and then the second thing, actually, like before we start the event, I noticed that you already have a little conversation with Mr. Sumardi. All right, Mr. Sumardi is actually one of the Pakuan University lecturer, which is have quite long experience in banking industry. Maybe Mr. Sumardi would like to share some comment, maybe, or some question before we go to Q&A session. Mr. Sumardi, can you hear us? Are you still with us?
Yeah, I'm still with you.
Okay, Pak Sumardi, maybe you can give a comment or question maybe regarding the presentation.
Yeah, in the pandemic era like now, is your banking more in funding activity, lending activity, or services activity?
Cannot handle.
All right.
Yeah, bad connection. Sorry.
Yeah.
Sorry, Mr. Sumardi, can you repeat again the question? Maybe to make it clear once again, sir, if you don't mind.
Yeah, I want again? To ask you, Ms. Naima, in the pandemic era like now, what is the best activities in your bank? Funding, lending, or services? So
okay.
From the your presentation, I think your activities most in the service activity, like
services business. Businesses, yeah. In this pandemic area, because all of the businesses are going to dead. And there are many people that doesn't have jobs. If in this scenario banks only focus on the getting deposits, I think so it should be, or it would be a foolish decision for them to just push their customers and knock the door of the customers and ask them to give us the deposit. How do people can give you the deposit? They don't have money. Why you people cannot understand? Then if they push me, miss, why you withdraw your deposit? Mister, I don't have money. In this pandemic, I spend all of my money on different things. So I am not doing the job. So I think so you should understand, because in this pandemic, I left my job. So then banks are trying to facilitate their clients in any way, because one most important thing for the banks, bank never goes in loss in any terms. Bank never goes in loss. Like if bank lend the money, they lend the money on interest base. If the bank get the deposit, they get the deposit and they offer interest. So if the bank is lending the money, they are giving the money to the customer, which every banking institution do have in their budget to offer to the customer. So that's why they just can get the loan and they can repay. In this scenario, banks, there are banks, even banks are focusing to get the deposit, but as well as simultaneously, they are trying to get the trust for their clients to offering them a loan or lending them the loans for business purpose, for different purpose on low interest rate. So that's why bank at least can get the money from by getting while customer pays the installment and interest as well. It's also earning. And even banks are still giving the credit cards to their customers, giving different kind of like finances to their customers in any term. But in this case, banks need to spend the money first. Like if I am financing to someone, it's okay. I am getting amount from the people in the shape of interest. But first I have to pay to them from my hand. There are banks, if you are also expert for banking, you may know, because there are banks who follow the strategies. Sometimes they observe the trend for market. They do the research in market. And they find out what is more needed in this era. So after that, finding out what is more needed in this era, they start offering that kind of services to their clients. So that's why they can earn easily. This strategy is also also following the banks. If there is a bank, they are only following the strategies like just getting the money from customers and not focusing the customers' need and not giving them the benefits in terms of financing, in terms of if someone trying to export their products for the business purpose. Even you and me and everyone knows very well. Import and export becomes very difficult in COVID because due to COVID, there are a lot of restrictions and these things cannot happen. And if there is a person still able to manage to do this thing and bank is not cooperating with them, I think so bank will lose that customer forever. So these kind of strategies bank is making and trying to facilitate the clients.
Okay. Mr. Sumardi, is there any more comment maybe? Or
okay, enough. That
you would like
Thank
to
you.
Say more?
Oh,
okay. Okay, Dr. Naima, actually, we already have a question here in the chat box. I think the question, let me check first, came from, name is Ahmad Irfan, is one of the students from Pakuan University. Actually, some part of the message is in Indonesia, but okay. But I think this is very good question. Yeah. The banking industry play an important role in country's fundamentals. However, currently the banking industry has been severely affected by pandemic to the point that Bank Indonesia is actually like a defeat in USA, but that's belong to Indonesia, has lowered the BI or the rate, yeah, the interest reference rate to the lowest 3.5% from the previous years. Automatically, the bank lending rate must also go down, not to mention there is a credit risk, a market risk, liquidity risk, operation risk, and so how do the bank survive in this present with the condition that they don't know when this will end, and not to mention having fight their competitors, namely P2P lending? Because in Indonesia, there is a P2P lending, right? Like a peer-to-peer lending or a fintech like that. Okay, even at the end, the day bank will definitely be needed. What do you think about this question? Because this is like a two coin of side, right? In one side, they need to be very prudent, all right, to make a curation whether to lend it, but on the other hand, they also need to boost the economic because people also need help. What do you think, Dr. Naima? Thank you.
Actually, in this scenario, the banks, because banks are lending and lowering the rate, okay. If we think about the bank side, because bank already have lowering the rate and lending. First, because of the lowering the rate and high need in the society for money, more people are going to bank and getting the money. In this case, bank do have more customers and bank have chance to collect them more interest. Because if I do have a product and I am selling that product in $20, but my competitor have that same product and he is selling that product in $5, maybe he can get the 10 customers and I only can get one or two customers. So this is also a scenario. Secondly, because there is one bank is on, banks also do have previously bodies to get the loan and banks are also insured. In a kind of pandemic, in kind of situations, bank can get the loans from different parties, from different bodies, from wherever they are insured, from wherever they have signed their MOUs, they can get the money from that side. Okay, and bank will never go in the dip or in the situation to swipe out from the market. But still, there are chances. See, if there is any bank that can sustain, so they can introduce. You give me an example of Bank Indonesia. There are multiple banks are working in the Indonesia. But there are two or three banks following different strategies. Other cannot follow that strategy. That means that banks do have capacity to sustain in the market. The other banks who don't have capacity to sustain in the market, they are not offering the things. If I do have a capacity, I can take a risk and jump in the market and get the benefit and come back. But sometimes, because in this situation, sometimes we need to take more risk for the lesser benefit. This situation is happening in our side here in this pandemic for around the world. The other banks who cannot or who has difficulty to manage, they are not following these kind of approaches. They are just trying to sustain themselves. They are just trying to reduce their budget from other things. But the one who do have capacity, they are giving more marketing campaigns on all of the medias. For me, I never saw for all banks giving the equal campaigns, because everyone is not equal. Fingers are not equal for banking also. This is the scenario. And Mr. Irie, can you tell me the second perspective for this question?
Okay, you mean regarding the question, the first question. Okay, I think I also agree with you, Dr. Naima. In Indonesia also, the situation is very dynamic. I mean, we know, as we notice, that both banking from the government, I mean, belong to government, or state-owned bank, or maybe commercial one belong to private sector. I mean, both of them are very prudent, are very careful to lending some money, especially during the pandemic. As we notice that high risk, high return, but most of the company are struggling during the pandemic. So actually they are trying to slow down the lending, because the risk is quite big, because they are really concerned about NPL or non-performing loan. But on the other hand, because there is also a bank belong to the government, which is they have a kind of what I call it package as an incentive, right, to boost the economy. So they are trying to aiming the small medium enterprise. Maybe for your information, speaking about small medium enterprise, if we talk about the numbers in Indonesia, actually 90% is small medium enterprise. So our government is really focused on that, Dr. Naima. So I can say that there is many incentive that actually our government already did their best during the pandemic, especially in 2020, right? Oh, like a very small loan, right? Very low rate also. They hope that actually this is going to be, you know, you got a loan for the first time and then you cannot get for the second time, because government expect you or expect another person or another company to get the loan. So everyone will get the benefit. So maybe that's my perspective or additional information, Ms. Naima. And then I think I agree with you. That's really depend on the strategy that the banking has. Yeah. All right. And also I would like to say hello to the another lecturers in Pakuan University, because it's not only Mr. Sumardi. Mr. in Indonesia, we call it Pak, yeah. Pak Sumardi is like Mr. Sumardi. And Miss, we call it Bu, yeah, because there is a Bu Mei or Miss Mei, actually, and also Miss Nina, the lecturer from Pakuan University. Maybe if Miss Mei or Miss Nina have a question, please do not hesitate to interrupt, right? Okay, we already have the second question, Dr. Aima. I think because your presentation is very good, there is another question. The question came from Andre. The name of the student is Andre. He asked that marketing management is both an art and a science, right? As an art, marketing management is a unique for every organization. As a science, there are standard procedure and can be followed by every organization. So the question is, what do you think combining art and science in developing a good banking material strategy? Even though actually you already mentioned about this one, maybe you can give more emphasis on that.
Mm-hmm. Actually, I'm really happy hearing the question from him. actually, this is not a question. This is a statement, and which is very good from the person, because a mix of marketing and science and art is very great, because already banking sector is trying to do this. And in this era, if someone is just focusing the art, they cannot win the marketing. If they want, they are just trying to follow the antiquated marketing strategies, it's not lead them to anywhere, because the antiquated marketing strategies already has been out now. That just giving the role of 50% or less than 50%. But like the digital marketing, and even see, when we are doing the digital marketing, we are doing different things. In that, always need to design the ad, always need to bring a new idea. There is innovation, there is creativity, there is science, there is art. And if there is no mix of these things, we cannot go to win the market in any business. The books that I recommend at the end of this slide will help anyone, if the person is individually doing the business also, only not for limited for banking sector. If an individual trying to do the business and need to follow the strategies, what kind of strategies I have to promote my business, even that business is very small, like making the cakes, making the cookies and selling them, that person can just get the strategies, how I can give the marketing technique and how I can market my business. And for banking sector, because they do have budget, they can bring many things, and all of the techniques, marketing, science, every technique in one platform, and give to their customer to attract them. And even you can see there are many people, many banks who brings the celebrity in. The reason is why, because they want to win. So the suggestion from his side is very good, and already there are banking sector following this. And if there is someone like we can say, commercial banks are following these things, but there are some banks like we can say only working as a lending bank or microfinance banks. Their strategies are quite different, but still they are now starting start following, and they should also need to follow these kind of strategies.
Okay, Dr. Naima, I think that's very, very good feedback from your side. But looking for your resume, actually, your CV, your experience before, and then I also take a look your doctorate dissertation. And then there is one thing that actually really make me, interested, is about Islamic banking. Can you tell us more about Islamic banking in Pakistan? Maybe if I can share to you, actually in Indonesia, there are many Islamic banking. We call it Syariah banking. But now Syariah, and then the top three big or best banking in Indonesia, BNI, Mandiri, and BRI Syariah, already merged into one banking. So the name of Indonesian banking right now, which is belong to government or state, is Bank Syariah Indonesia, or BSI. So can you tell us more about Islamic banking in Pakistan?
Okay, in Pakistan, there are 5 banks who are working completely full-fledged Islamic banks. Okay. But there are other banks also trying to bring standalone windows, and they are trying to open one Islamic banking branch, but try to there are 2 counters for conventional banking, and try to open one counter for Islamic banking in them. After 2009, they got the license in Pakistan. for Islamic banking and doing practices for Islamic banking. And Mizan Bank was the one who is top on the list and get a license for Islamic banking. Mizan Bank is Mizan Bank is the one who is doing completely full-fledged working for Islamic banking. But the thing is that I think so, being a Muslim country, we Pakistani are Indian, Malaysians, and even Indonesians, every country is still at the point to struggling either this Islamic banking is purely Islamic banking or not. Because in conventional banking, we are saying interest. In Islamic banking, we are picking our ear from this side and we are saying Sharia and these kind of terms we are using.
Profit sharing. Kind of profit sharing, maybe.
Yeah.
We call it profit sharing, right?
Yeah. Yeah, yes, yes. So, but there are scholars, there are researchers still struggling to bring more pure things for Islamic banking, more pure terms and more pure, like how our investments would be pure without investing in different things. And see, the conventional, if you see the product mix, or mix for conventional banking, wherever they are investing their money. The investing their money is the way from where they can getting the profit. We can say somehow maybe illegal, or maybe in a way that a Muslim itself, I say, oh, if I were, I will not invest my amount in this thing. I will not my amount in this thing. But Islamic banking is try to mix the products in a way where they can get the product mix a pure Islamic concept, like investing of different platforms, investing in SCCP, investing in different things and bring the profit to the customers. And even for both bankings, there is one thing same. The same thing is that on a certain base, but Islamic banking is also giving the interest, but they are saying it will fluctuate. Conventional banking interest is also fluctuating. So that's why still researchers, scholars are working to make these things and mix of the products and terms more pure. But we, as a customer, as a client, we are saying it's okay, no problem, because I tell you one thing, if Qari, Ulama, and the person who is appointed at the Sharia give a written document that this thing is halal and we believe and follow it's up to us if we follow on the behalf of that person, the things, the sin will be at that person, because we are following. We are followers, and they give us the direction, they give us and tell us the knowledge about the thing. This thing is right in a way. So that's why it's okay. And still there are more researches, there are more things, and there are these kind of pure Islamic banking terms and pure Islamic banking products are halal. And people are doing and keeping their accounts in Islamic banking. So that's why, because of this reason, I also studied for Islamic banking, because as a banker, when I was working in conventional banking as a Muslim, my approach was also, I'm taking the salary from a place where the salary is interest-based, or this thing called sood. I don't want to take. So that's why I come to this field and study for Islamic banking and explore more things.
Okay, all right. That's very interesting. But maybe I will give more information or add more information to Dr. Naima. Actually, in Indonesia, we are as part of Southeast Asia, or under name of Asian. In Asian countries, the total population of Asian countries is 600 million population.
Okay.
And then half of them, I mean more, almost 300 million is actually Indonesian people, because our population is 280, right?
Okay.
But from 280, more than 80%, almost 90% is a Muslim in Indonesia. So that's why we are not the Islamic country.
Pakistan.
Yeah. I think I mean, in terms of population, I think the market is there. The population is there. There is a plenty of room for Islamic banking to grow in Indonesia. That's maybe additional perspective and for your information, Dr. Naima.
Okay, thank you. Thank you.
All right. Okay. Maybe this is gonna be the third question, right? Okay, because I'm already asking about Islamic banking, and then we have two questions from the student. And then I got a one word which is very related with the banking. We call it inclusion. Inclusion, right? Because when we talk about digital, and then we cannot ignore that we are also definitely talking about digitalization, right? So let me share some information. I don't know what happened in Pakistan, but this is happened in Indonesia. Okay, but first I would like to mute some attendance. So okay, let me check first. I think everyone need to turn off the audio first, so we can continue this discussion from Sutra Manalu. Mr. Eka, can you help me to turn off the audio or microphone from Sutra Manalu? All right. From the 15th century until the 20th century, yeah, Dr. Naima, there is a traditional banking. Like there is an office, there is a branches, right? But starting 1980 and then 2007 in Indonesia, we call it self-service banking or ATM machine, right? But of course, this is different with the video that you already present before. And then 2007 until 2017, there is a smartphone and mobile banking, right? We call it banking everywhere. But now, 2019 until onward, I mean, there is an era of Internet of Things, era of AI, in artificial intelligence. Everything should be real time, right? Digital omnichannel. And also, especially during the pandemic, we try to minimum the physical distribution, right? So can you share us more about what happened, maybe especially in Pakistan? Related with the digitalization, because in Indonesia right now, I can tell you this is very recent news. In this year, one of the biggest bank in Indonesia, maybe the third largest in Indonesia, they just closed almost 100 branches. Dr. Naima, the call is Bank Negara Indonesia or BNI. That's actually belong to government, but they will proceed to close almost 100 branches. So I don't know what happened in Pakistan. Can you tell us more? Because digitalization is something that actually already begun. Thank you. Sorry, Dr. Naima, I think your microphone still mute. Maybe you can unmute again. I'm sorry for that one.
Okay, no problem. Actually, due to this digitalization for every industry and especially in banking sector, people previously were going to the branch and doing their transaction. Now, what Pakistan is doing, because we are a developing country, what Pakistan is doing currently, there are different branches that start digital branches. The concept is digital branches is entirely different. The branches have staff members like one or two staff. Previously, if there is one branch, 15 staff members or somehow 20 staff members, there is one customer service officer, branch manager, relationship officers, relationship managers, credit officers, all kind of these people were in the branch. But the branches that introduce, make the branches as a digital branches, their branches have only LCDs and ATM machine, a cash deposit machine, and all transactions are digital. There is one or two staff members, like one is working to open the accounts and the other one is working to manage the things like at the counter, or somehow they just remove the counters. Still, in the Pakistan, there are the banks. They just reduce one, two, or three branches, or maybe some branches, not more branches, because making the bank branches digital or digitalization and implementing complete digitalization is very expensive process. It's not a cheap process for any bank. So that's why even before 3 to 4 years, there are 2 or 3 banks who were more actively performing digitalization. They convert their some branches into digital branches, but they never close that branches because of visibility. At least customer should see the branch and customer come in the branch. Or even there are majority of the population, there are few people who are very educated, and then also there are people who are just having a limited education, or there are people who do have thumb impressions also. So according to the things, like we also need to the thing that I discussed previously in my slide, we should have the information, our demographics. According to the demographics of Pakistan, we cannot close like 100 branches or many branches from all of the all of the cities. In Lahore, okay, it's a big city. We can close 4 branches, 5 branches, but closing the branch is also a thing that we are reducing the revenue because there is a huge competition of the banks. So making a branch digital, and bank is spending expense on that branch. Then the most important thing is also educate your population, your audience. So the stakeholder, if the stakeholder is not educated, you cannot win the market in this situation. First, in Pakistan, what they are trying to do, they are educating their people to follow and to adopt the technology. Let's see, my mother, she's good and she's very technology friendly. Always she plays a game, but for banking things, she always asks me, "What will do? I will not do." In this situation, there are things we cannot close the branches that are customer friendly. If my mom goes to the counter and the person is there and serve her all of the things, I think so. This is more better for her to follow the digital things. So in this perspective, Pakistan has converted the branches into digital branches, but never focused to close many branches. Maybe it will happen in the future, but still, as of now, things are not happening like this.
I think there is many common between Pakistan and Indonesia, because I mean, both of our countries actually still in developing stage. And then yes. I also agree with you, Dr. Naima, that even though that online is growing, but we cannot ignore about the offline, yeah? Because some people, yeah, especially maybe the X generation or maybe the baby boomers generation, they still need that kind of branches, right? Okay. Yeah. But I also would like to share information with you about Indonesian banking. You know that marketplace is growing anywhere, right? Speaking about regional area,
there is our voice is interrupting.
Oh, I'm sorry. What about right now? Is it better right now?
Yes, it is better. Can you speak again?
Okay. Speaking about digitalization, we also actually speaking about the marketplace, you know, marketplace just like AliExpress, just like Amazon, right? But yes, we also have here in Asia, we have a Shopee, but Indonesia, we have Tokopedia and Bukalapak. Right now, they are bigger and bigger. Okay. You know, the power of being number one or market leader, you can kill someone or maybe you can eat someone, right? So, you know, one of the development in Indonesia, some marketplace is actually become very, very powerful. And then finally, yeah, maybe about last week, they just open banking because they have a very superpower in marketplace. They can notice about the customer behavior. They have everything because they also merge with our transportation online, right? We call it Gojek. And then become one big company, we call it GoTo, right? And then now they have one banking, they call it is Bank Jago. Bank is bank in Indonesia. Jago, it means that you are very powerful. That's very Indonesian, it's Indonesian name. Jago is a powerful. Okay. You like a superhero. You can do everything, right?
In Pakistan,
the name is Bang. Yes.
Sorry. In Pakistan, Jago means wake up from sleep.
Okay, wake up from sleep. Yeah, that means Jago. Yeah. But in Indonesia, Jago means that you can do anything because you are powerful. Okay. Bang Jago is actually one of the digital banking, which is disrupt, you know, the industrial overall, because the Bank Jago is the first banking which is open the bank without have any branches. Is that correct, Pak Sumardi? Like that?
Okay.
The situation? Yeah. I think the situation is like that, Dr. Naima. There is a phenomenon in Indonesia. I don't know what happened in Pakistan. Is that something happened like that? There is one bank that actually don't have any branches. So our government, the state regulation, which is control about the banking, they also actually one step behind. And then now they are trying to formulate the new regulation for that one. So that's the situation. I just give another or additional information. Okay. What do you think about that one?
For Pakistan, State Bank of Pakistan is here to manage all of the banks and to issue the regulations, monetary policies, and other policies which banks should be followed. And there are also things that if the customer do have complaint, customer do have right to make the complaint in the bank, or otherwise bank is not hearing the complaint, then customer went to the banking mortisib, means register their complaint in State Bank. And State Bank is the one body who regulate all of the banks, and all of the banks are obliged to report to the State Bank. Otherwise, if the bank is not following the policies, monetary terms, and all of the regulations of State Bank, the bank will get imposed a heavy fine, or maybe the bank requires to close their activities. So for every country, there is a State Bank they are staying one step behind. They are not directly serving the customer, but they are taking care of all of the population and making the policies, making the rules, and spread that rules to all of the banks, and have their management staff who are managing the banks and visit to the banks to see either the bank are following the rules and regulations or not, or they are just running the bank beyond the policies and whatever the people want to do. This thing, we can say they hire the mystery shoppers, they hire their staff members, and they send to the branches, because obviously every organization requires a proper rules and regulations. Without rules and regulations, nothing can be go smoothly.
Okay, Dr. Naima, I think that's very crystal clear, but I promise you this is going to be the last question, yeah, because I'm a little bit curious about Pakistan, especially about the social media, right?
Okay.
Can you tell us more about social media in Pakistan, especially which is might be related with the banking industry? How powerful actually social media in banking industry, especially in your country?
Oh my God, because around the world, social media is very popular, same as in my country. There is one thing, just pin drops and social media start telling you.
Everybody know, yeah? Everybody know, yeah, right.
Everything goes viral. Even there is one story, there is one thing, and even right now, you know, TikTok, Snapchat, apps and different things. Still, banking is also using different kind of medias, like making the stories and to making the things, making different clips. Like, see, whatever I did, this is the video was the example from ITU Bank. And then they make the video. Because they facilitate the customers, they make the video and they just put it on YouTube, on other platforms. Same is happening here, because if you do have any app for social media, things start popping up, and still social media is playing very important role in selection of anything, like in selection of bank, in selection of cloth brands, in selection of parlor. Last time I was just using Instagram and I was looking which brand give the more deals for shoes, for clothes, for parlor. Then I just select from social media. I just find the rating, I find everything, and I select this. And same thing is happening. And in this era, there are bad things also. If there is an annoyed customer, a satisfied customer somehow can bring two customers, or maybe sometimes not bring any customer. But an annoyed customer is successfully take off 4 to 5 customers of yours. Because if I do have bad banking experience, what I can do? I will sit and spread, this bank never deals me good. This bank did this thing. This bank did this thing. Maybe the 5 or 10 people are prospect customers of that bank. But what I did from my word of mouth, I just try to convey the message, don't be a customer of that bank. This is only my word of mouth. But if someone goes to social media, and if an annoyed customer report his bad experience, his or her bad experience on social media, this thing is very drastic, I think so. And it happens. I saw if a customer have bad experience, they make a complaint to a CEO and make the complaints to many people. One of our staff members, one of our staff member, the person was going to use the ATM, and the person went to ATM. There was a client outside, and client asked the employee, client asked the employee, please use first, because that was lady. And then the employee used the ATM, and after that, what happened, client just went, and then he complained, I was outside, and then this person used the ATM, and it is really ridiculous. This thing, that thing, this thing, and then the person make the complaint to CEO. There are no reason. These kind of things happen because people are now trying to be over sharp and clever also. So this is regarding social media. If anything, good thing comes on social media, it will create a good image. If the bad thing comes on social media, it will ruin the image. So in Pakistan, social media, I don't know in Indonesia, but in Pakistan, very active. We are sick of social media.
Yeah, I think everyone right now is crazy about social media because they spend time, maybe more than 10 hours per day, just to, you know, interact with the smartphone. Yeah. I think that video that you just present, you know, the ATM, the interactive ATM is very powerful one, because we are right now is, you know, we are lack of interaction, by the way, because we are keep busy with our smartphone. That's all. I think everything has become viral in social media. And then I agree with you, everything which is very good will become viral. One customer can bring you 2 customer, but disappointed customer will bring you down for many customer. Okay, Dr. Naima, I think everything is perfect. Everything is on schedule. You know, because it's almost 2 hours. In Pakistan, maybe it's almost, 1 p.m., right? Almost 1 p.m. And then we almost 1 p.m. We already actually have a very good and very nice 2 hours to have discussion. And then let me maybe close this session. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, distinguished lecturers and students, on behalf of University of Pakuan, as a moderator, I would like to say thank you very much to our honorable guest, Dr. Naima. And I also would like to thank you to Dr. Faradia, because from Dr. Faradia effort and Dr. Naima, also we can realize this, international public lecturer. And then second thing, I also would like to apologize if there are any mistake during the event. We know that this is not easy to to make a such online lecturer, because there are of course many challenges, maybe connection problem, different time, but alhamdulillah we made it. Hopefully this event will beneficial for all of us. Last but not least, please open up or turn on your video, or please on cam, because we still have a photo section, Dr. Naima. Because if we take a look at the number of the participant, the number is almost at 160. Now it's actually still almost the same, like 130. This is one of the evidence or one of the proof that actually many participant or audience is really appreciate your presentation. And then I think we got many knowledge from your presentation. Okay, please everyone, please open up the video. Mas Eka, boleh pinnya dihilangkan dulu Mas Eka, supaya kita bisa ambil sesi foto. I think we need to take a picture because we are along with our beautiful guest, Dr. Naima, and then all the Indonesian here. Please, student, please, all the colleague to on cam. Please remove the pin, Mr. Eka, so we can see. Okay, this is all the faces from Indonesian student. Yeah. Please say hi. Yes,
hi. There is also participants from Pakistan. Our speaker yesterday, Dr. Mudazir Zafarid, also participate in this session. Hi, Dr. Mudazir. So
good afternoon, Dr. Mudazir Zafarid.
Yeah, thank you so much for calling me.
Maybe after pandemic, Dr. Mudazir and also Dr. Naima can come to Bogor, to Indonesia, and then we are actually very welcome on that.
Yes, sure. Why not? I still remember you last time we met, if you remember.
All right. Oh my God. Yeah. I still remember you actually, but you are more handsome than before actually, and then younger than before. I don't know. Yeah. I don't know what kind of supplement actually. I want to buy it.
actually, right now you are looking me in a beard shape. That's why I am looking different from the previous one.
Yeah. Because the first time I saw you, I thought you are Sahrul Khan actually. But you know, the second time, oh, you are not Sahrul Khan. Just Mr. Mudazir, Dr. Mudazir. Nice to meet you again, sir.
Yeah, thank you so much. And me and Dr. Naima both are willing to come to Indonesia, and inshallah next time if you call us, surely.
Okay, inshallah. Thank you, Dr. Mudazir.
Yeah,
and then actually we have a 5 screen here, and then we try to capture the screen number 1. Tolong Pak Mas Eka ya, kita screen number 1. Please give your big smile and maybe your best style, maybe like that, like Korean style, like Sarangyo style, or UK Wakanda style, or whatever. Okay, we can start with the screen number 1, and then 1, 2, 3. What we call it in Pakistan, 1, 2, 3? Can you mention?
Ek do tin.
Kek do tin. Okay, we do it in Pakistan. Kek do tin. All right, that's the screen number 2, screen number 3. Okay, I call it
in different
language.
Yeah, you can also call in Indonesian language.
Indonesian language. 1, 2, 3. And we also have a traditional language because we are from West Java. We call it Sunda language. 1, 2, 3. Ah, hajar bleh. Nah, yang ketiga ya, yang keempat tadi. And then the last one. Iersan. Nah, ini buat yang suka nonton film-film. Okay. Siap, everybody say kimchi, and then thank you very much, kamsahamida, syukran. Dr. Naima, thank you very much for your good presentation, and also Dr. Mudazir. Hope we can see you each other offline, of course, in very short time. Once again, thank you very much. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you, Dr. Faradia.
Thank you, Dr. Naima. See you again, everyone.
Thank you, all participants.
Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Thank you, Bu Faradia, and everyone. Dr. Mudazir, thank you.
Thank you.
Bye-bye, Bu Dosen.
Bye-bye. Waalaikumsalam.
Terima kasih Bu Dewi Maharani, Pak Patar Simamora. Aduh, udah lama nggak ketemu. Bu Dewi, makasih Bu, dari kemarin ikut join.
Iya, alhamdulillah ada waktu Bu, alhamdulillah. Ya. Acaranya bagus Bu.
Nanti insya Allah ada lagi Bu Dewi di hari Rabu Bu, tapi posternya belum di-sharing. Kalau yang hari Rabu mengenai research methodology Bu Dewi.
Insya Allah kalau tidak ada kelas saya bisa, insya Allah.
Iya Bu, jadi nanti juga buat pengetahuan ke para mahasiswa membuat apa namanya tambahan pemahaman mengenai pembuatan skripsi ya atau ilmiah, artikel ilmiah. Tapi nanti kalau tanggal 2 itu dari Malaysia Bu, dan ada juga perwakilan dari mahasiswa kita yang akan buat kayak mini kolokium gitu Bu Dewi. Nanti ada yang sharing. Jadi ada perwakilan dari prodi satu aja sih, prodi manajemen satu, prodi akuntansi satu, sama yang dari universitas yang di Malaysia. Kita bisa berbagi seperti apa cara mereka presentasi proposal riset maupun penelitiannya. Nanti dikabarin lagi Bu.
Oh iya baik Bu, ditunggu kabarnya Bu.
Iya.
Sukses terus Bu acaranya. Sukses terus Bu acaranya.
Amin, amin, amin. Pak Patar, apa kabar? Aduh, gak sambil ngajar kali Bapak ya.
Saya izin ref ya Bu.
Assalamualaikum. Ya, mangga-mangga Bu, saya juga mau. Waalaikumsalam, saya juga mau ref. Baik, para mahasiswa, terima kasih perhatiannya, kontribusinya. Saya izin ref, semoga sehat-sehat selalu. Terima kasih Mas Eka, hostnya. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Cek, cek.